Hi viewers, in this class we are going to discuss the respiratory system of Calotes. As the Calotes is completely terrestrial animal, it is a true lung breather. That is, it shows the pulmonary respiration. Pulmonary respiration is a respiration which takes place through the lungs. Otherwise, the lungs are the main important respiratory organs. Structurally, the pulmonary respiratory organs do not show any great improvement over the amphibians, but functionally the lungs have become more efficient when compared to the amphibians. Cloacal respiration is also found in some of the sea turtles. Cutaneous respiration is also takes place in some sea snakes and the turtles. Here, the respiratory system of the Calotes, for our convenience, divided into two subheadings. First one is the route of respiration and second one is the respiratory organs. Let us start with the route of respiration. The route of respiration starts with the pair of nostrils or external nares. External nostrils situated a little ahead of the eyes. The nostrils lead to the nasal passage, which opens into the roof of the buccal cavity through the internal nostrils. A longitudinal slit-like glottis is present between the basal bifurcation of the tongue. The glottis opens into the larynx, which is a box-shaped structure, and it is made up of a pair of arytenoids and a single cricoid cartilage. That indicates larynx gets supported by three cartilage in structures. One is the cricoid cartilage, remaining two are the arytenoid cartilages. So these three structures covers, protects and supports the larynx. These two arytenoid cartilages unite posteriorly with the anterolateral sides of the cricoid cartilage. Anteriorly, the arytenoid cartilage support the corresponding lips of the glottis. The larynx is connected with two pairs of muscles known as musculus compressor laryngis, which act as a sphincter of the glottis, and another one, musculus dilator laryngis, which helps in opening of the larynx. Then the larynx opens into the trachea. Which is a narrow tube-like structure, and beset with complete cartilaginous tracheal rings, which prevent the trachea from the collapsing. The trachea is bifurcated into two branches to form a pair of narrow passage called bronchi. The two bronchi are also supported by cartilaginous rings. Each bronchus is connected with the corresponding lung. Let us see the structure. Here you can see this is the larynx supported by two arytenoid cartilages and another cricoid cartilage. These are the supporting cartilaginous structures. Then this is the trachea. And supported by the complete cartilaginous rings, which protects the trachea from the collapsing. Here these are the two branches which are called as the bronchi. Each and every bronchi connected to the respective lung. This is the right lung and this is the left lung. Coming to the lungs. A pair of lungs are present in the thoracic cavity, one on either side of the heart. The lungs are elongated sac-like structures. The right lung is slightly larger than the left lung. Lungs are thin-walled, fusiform sacs of orange color. Internally, each lung is incompletely divided into small chambers, which are called as the alveoli. Alveoli are the structural and functional units of the lungs. The alveoli are the actual areas where exchange of gas occurs. In the distal part of the lung, such chambers are almost absent. This non-partitioned posterior part of the lung is considered as a reservoir for the residual air. It constitutes about 1/3 of the whole lung. The wall of the lung is made up of squamous epithelium, very, very important bit. The anterior part of the lung, is more sacculated due to the presence of more alveoli. This part is respiratory, serving for the exchange of gases. As a result, the blood supply is more at the anterior end of the lung. So these are the lungs. See here, the important points are to be remembered. A larynx supported by 3 cartilage plates, 1 cricoid plate, 2 arytenoid plates. Larynx has 2 pairs of muscles, musculus compressor laryngeus, which acts like the sphincter of the glottis, and musculus dilator laryngeus, which helps in the opening of the larynx. And see the mechanism of respiration. The chemical mechanism of respiration is basically similar in all the vertebrates, but the physical mechanism varies in many forms. The physical mechanism is divided into 2 steps. They are inspiration and the expiration. Both inspiration as well as expiration are brought about by ribs and intercostal muscles in the thoracic cavity. Inspiration is caused by the movement of the intercostal muscles, which raise the ribs, and by increasing the volume of thorax, reduce lung pressure and cause an inflow of air inside the lungs. Whereas the expiration is caused by lowering the ribs through the contraction of intercostal muscles and decreasing thoracic volume. The lungs are pressed and the foul air or carbon dioxide passes out of the lungs through the respiratory tract to outside. So here the route of respiration, you can see. So during the inspiration, the air enters from environment into the external nostrils, then nasal passage, then internal nostrils, glottis, larynx, trachea, bronchia and lungs, finally into the alveoli. In between the alveoli and the blood capillary bed, there is a mutual exchange of the gas in between the blood and as well as the respiratory surfaces. And in turn, during the expiration, the air goes out. Carbon dioxide air goes out from the alveoli to lungs, bronchi, trachea, larynx, glottis, internal nostrils, nasal passage, external nostrils and to the outside. This is the route of respiration, inspiration and the expiration. So this is all about respiratory organs and the process of respiration. Thank you one and all.